bound for glory, this train. This train is bound for glory, this train. This train is bound for glory. Jesus made a place in heaven for me. This train is bound for glory, this train. This train is bound for glory, this train. This train is bound for glory, this train. This train is bound for glory. Jesus made a place in heaven for me. This train is bound for glory, this train.
Okay, now let's bring it down.
This train is bound for glory, this train. This train is bound for glory, this train. This train is bound for glory. Jesus made a place in heaven for me. This train is bound for glory, this train.
Oh, this train.
This train is bound for glory, this train. This train is bound for glory, this train. Place in heaven for me. This train is bound for glory. This train.
This train. Oh, yeah.
This train. This train.
Okay, boys and girls, mom and dad, stand up. Let's stand right. Of the United States of America, and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Stay standing, and let's sing My Country 'Tis of Thee. I pledge allegiance to the Christian flag and to the Savior for whose kingdom it stands, one Savior, crucified, risen, and coming again with life and liberty to all who believe. Okay, joy is the flag. Ready? Joy is the flag flown high. Joy is the flag flown high from the castle of my heart. Bible. I pledge allegiance to the Bible, God's holy word. I will make it a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path. I will hide its words in my heart that I might not sin against God. The B-I-B-L-E.
The B-I-B-L-E. Yes, that's the good for me.
go. Welcome to day 5 of Vacation Bible School and Rocky Railways VBS. We thank Group for publishing this, especially this online Vacation Bible School. It wasn't ideal. Much rather have you guys in here and hugging you and singing Let's Stand Up, Sing Out like 500 times. But at least you got to do things 5 different days. And parents and grandparents, thank you. You are a special part of this Vacation Bible School, because without you, it wouldn't have happened. Thank you for coming and picking up your packets. Thank you for taking time each day to set aside to study God's Word. And I hope it was beneficial to you. We just pray that next year we're in here in the sanctuary. We have 140 children running around, the teachers going crazy, thinking, oh my goodness, you know, how many more kids can we fit in a classroom? But there's always room, because in Jesus's kingdom, there's always room for one more. And boys and girls, we're standing here at this wall at Faith Baptist Church. And the reason why we have light bulbs up here is for the people that have accepted Jesus into their lives. And we pray that you are one of them. But let's go to day 5, okay? Day 5, our theme is Jesus' power helps us to be good friends. And I want you to think of a time when you are a good friend. Or you have a good friend. Talk about that with your parents or the person that's leading that. Talk about what it means to be a good friend, or who's been a good friend to you and what qualities they have. Well, boys and girls, back in our Bible lesson today, we're going to talk about the early church, and that's found in Acts. That's in the New Testament. And you're going to find out how those people lived together and how they came together as a community. Boys and girls, you have a wonderful family, and you have your own community at your home. But boys and girls, when you start school, you'll have a community with your class, or you might go to gymnastics and you have a community with them. And how can we be good friends in Jesus to help them? And our Bible verse comes from John 15:12. It says, love each other in the same way I have loved you. Boys and girls, can you imagine if everybody loved us like Jesus' love, or we loved everybody else like Jesus loves us? Oh my goodness, wouldn't this world be a different place? But boys and girls, you can do that, because once you have Jesus in your heart, then you're to live like him. And he gives you gifts from the Holy Spirit that you can say, oh, I can now have joy. I can have peace. I can have patience. I can have understanding. I can have all these different things, because that's who Jesus is. We can't do it on our own, but once we have Jesus in our heart, we can surely do it. And boys and girls, today you brought your quarters for offering. Now you have pennies and nickels and dimes and quarters. What are you going to do with it? I'm sure pray about it and see where God leads you to put your offering. Thank you for joining us these 5 days. I hope it has been a wonderful experience for you as it has been for me. And in your packet on day 5, you have a special envelope with your name on it. And it's something special that you and your parents can go to and have a special treat. So thank you for being with us these 5 days. I pray that God has just laid upon your heart how important it is to know him, trust him, and how much he helps us to be bold and have hope and to live forever and to have good friends and be a good friend. And how it is to live like Jesus lives. So boys and girls, let's close with our last time of prayer. Stay on for the skit, and then parents, thank you again so much. Let's pray. Dear God, thank you for this great 5 days of Vacation Bible School. Thank you so much for the people that put it together so we can learn more about you and that we can trust you in anything and everything in our lives. Dear Lord, we couldn't have done this without the parents or the children being involved. And thank you for Faith Baptist Church and everybody here that has prayed for you guys to have a great 5 days. Lord, next year we're going to not take for granted that prayerfully we can be together and just running around the church learning more about you. But Lord, it's just not about 5 days. It's every day of our life. So for the next 360 days, may we just be ready to learn more about you and be in your word. And then on day 361, we'll be back here at the church singing, Let's Stand Up, Sing Out, because we want to make a joyful noise to you. We want to stand for you. We want to sit for you. We want to walk with you. We want to read the Bible and learn more about you. We want to pray to you. And Lord, let us not waste a day. And thank you for these 5 days. It's in Jesus' name I pray. Amen. Thank you, boys and girls. It has been a great 5 days. Kay, come in and call and see us. Come to church. We'd love to see you anytime. Love you all.
No, just stay there. I've got it. No, it's fine. I'm taking care of it. Just stay there.
Wow, Cam. You seem really steamed up. It seems like he's really going off the rails.
You're not helping.
Oh, I'm sorry.
It's a train engineer thing. You wouldn't understand.
Oh, yeah? Try me. I bet I can track right with you.
Really? You're gonna have to stop with the train jokes.
Okay, I'm listening. Well, but one more. I'm all engine ears. Okay, I'm listening.
Fine. Well, so two people usually drive a steam engine. The engineer.
Okay.
And the fireman.
A fireman? Like with a big red truck and a Dalmatian?
No, not like that. Like a fireman on a train engine is the person who shovels the coal and throws it into the fire to make all the steam.
Oh, okay. I'm tracking so far.
Anyway, we got a new fireman on my crew, and he is driving me crazy. He never, ever stops talking. All it ever is, hey, Cam, how you doing? I'm doing well. Hey, what's your favorite color? Mine's purple. Hey, you seem really old. How old are you? Oh, you're so old. Were you there when the train was invented? Hey, you want to hear a train joke? What do you call a train that's carrying bubblegum? A choo-choo train. That's so funny. Hey, why aren't you laughing, Cam? You don't like me, Cam. I don't think you like me. Well, that's okay. I'm going to make you like me. You want to hear another train joke? Why was the train so good at his job? Because he's in training.
Shh. Cam, it doesn't sound like you're being very nice to this person. It kind of sounds like you're making fun of them.
You just don't understand what it's like to be constantly interrupted when you're trying to work.
Oh. I think I have a pretty good idea of what that's like. Cam, being loving to others is so important. And if you're having a hard time being a good friend, you can ask Jesus for help. Jesus' power helps us be good friends.
Yeah, but what if someone just won't stop talking?
Jesus' power helps us be good friends. You should talk to Jesus. Pray to him and ask him for patience and for the eyes to see this new crew member the way Jesus sees him. Maybe this guy's lonely. Maybe he needs someone to talk to. You never know what someone's going through. And sometimes the people who annoy us the most are the ones who need our friendship the most.
Yeah, you're right. I guess I'll have some time on this long haul on our next journey to practice being a good friend. I'm gonna need the power of Jesus. Would you mind praying with me before I go?
Of course I will. We'll wrap up here and then we can pray together before you go on your trip. And who knows, maybe Jesus put this guy on your crew so that you can show him Jesus's love like no one else.
Me? A job only I can do?
Yeah.
That's pretty cool. Well, I'm gonna finish putting the supplies together for our next trip and then I'll come right back here so we can pray.
Okay, sounds good.